Welcome to EPG Parthshala. Today in this module, we are going to discuss about various wildlife conservation projects in India that has been initiated in India from time to time. The first biodiversity project was initiated in 1930. This module mainly focuses on animal conservation projects. We will discuss about various projects, which includes Project Tiger, Project Hangul, Project Elephant, Project Cheetah, Project Crocodile, Project Snow Leopard, and many others. So let's first go to introduction. What is wildlife? Why we need to conserve wildlife? Wildlife constitutes entire flora and fauna which grows in wild and not domesticated. It includes plants, animals, and microorganisms that are not domesticated by humans. Wildlife is an important component of biodiversity. We know that India is rich in diversity, but due to rapid industrialization, increase in population, increase in pollution, and high demands of food, hunting, etc., has led to over-exploitation and extinction of various important species of plants and animals. In order to prevent the extinction of the species, various conservation activities have been initiated. The first project that was initiated in India was in 1930, that was Jim Corbett National Park. This module mainly focuses on the animal conservation projects. So let's start with first project, that is Project Tiger. Project Tiger is one of the most successful conservation projects not only in India but also globally. The project was launched in the year 1973 based on the recommendations of a task force set up by the then Prime Minister of India, Mrs. Indira Gandhi. At initial stage, 9 tiger reserves were settled to be covered under this Project Tiger. With the time, these have increased to 50 in December 2016 and covered almost 71,027 kilometers area. It is spread in 18 states and covers around 2.21% of the geographical area of our country. Corbett National Park was the first national park of India to come under Project Tiger on April 1, 1973. These are the tiger reserves in India state-wise: Manas in Assam, Kaziranga in Assam, Nameri in Assam, Nagarjunga Sagar in Andhra Pradesh, Namdafa in Arunachal Pradesh, Pakke in Arunachal Pradesh, Valmiki in Bihar, Indravati in Chhattisgarh, Andati Sitandadi Chhattisgarh, Achanakmar Chhattisgarh, Palamau Jharkhand, Pariyar Kerala, Parambikulam Kerala, Bandipur Karnataka, Bhadra Karnataka, Dandeli Anchi in Karnataka, Nagarhole in Karnataka, Taduba Andhari in Maharashtra, Panch in Maharashtra, Melgut in Maharashtra, Bandhavgarh in Madhya Pradesh, Kanha in Madhya Pradesh, Satpura in Madhya Pradesh, Pinch in Madhya Pradesh, Dampa in Mizoram, Satkoshia in Orissa, Simlipal in Orissa, Satkoshia in Orissa, Simlipal in Orissa, Rathambhor, Rajasthan, Sariska, Rajasthan, Kalkat Mundanthurai in Tamil Nadu, Mudalmalai in Tamil Nadu, Annamalai in Tamil Nadu, Corbett in Uttarakhand, Dudhwa in Uttar Pradesh, Boksa in West Bengal, Sundarbans in West Bengal, Sahdari in Maharashtra, Amangarh in Uttar Pradesh, Malgut in Maharashtra, Biligari Ranganatha Temple in Karnataka, Kaval in Telangana, Satyamangalam in Tamil Nadu, Mukandra Hills in Rajasthan, Neveguan Nagzira in Maharashtra, Amrabad in Telangana, Pilibhit in Uttar Pradesh, Bor in Maharashtra, Rajaji Tiger Reserve in Uttarakhand, Orang Tiger Reserve in Assam, Kamlang Tiger Reserve in Arunachal Pradesh. Second one is Project Elephant. Project Elephant was launched in February 1992. Its aim was to provide financial and specialized help to significant elephant states among the nation for the security of elephants, their environments, habitats, and corridors. The project additionally covered the issues of human-elephant conflict and welfare of domesticated elephants. Currently, 32 elephant reserves are existing and occupied 69,583 square kilometers area. The major objectives of Project Elephant: to protect elephant's environment, habitat and corridors, address issues of man-animal conflict, welfare of captive elephants. The project is being implemented in 16 states and union territories, namely Andhra Pradesh, Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Jharkhand, Karnataka, Kerala, Meghalaya, Nagaland, Odisha, Tamil Nadu, Uttaranchal, Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal. Main activities under the project: development of scientific and plant management for conservation of elephant habitats and viable population of wild Asiatic elephants in India. Promotion of measures for mitigation of man-elephant conflict in crucial habitats and moderating pressures of human and domestic stock activities in crucial elephant habitats. Strengthening of measures for protection of wild elephants from poachers and unnatural causes of death. Research on elephant management related issues. Public education and awareness programs. Eco-development, veterinary care, elephant rehabilitation, rescue centers. Monitoring of illegal killing of elephant program. Mike program started in South Asia in the year 2003, provide information for elephant range states. The aim of this program was to build institutional capacity within the range states for long-term management of their populations, to measure levels and trends in the illegal hunting of elephants, to determine changes in these trends over time, to determine the factors causing or associated with such changes, and to try and assess in particular to what extent observed trends are a result of any decision taken by the Conference of Parties to CITES. Project Elephant has been officially implementing MIKE program of CITES in 10 elephant reserves in India since 2004. These consist of Shivalik in Uttarakhand, Mayurbhanj in Odisha, Nilgiri in Tamil Nadu, Ripuchirag and Dehing Patkai in Assam, Garo Hills in Meghalaya, Deomali in Arunachal Pradesh, Eastern Dwar in West Bengal, Wayanad in Kerala and Mysore, Karnataka. Next one is Project Hangul. It was initiated in the year 1970 with the help of World Wide Fund, that is WWF. Hangul, also called as Kashmir's Stag, scientific name is Cervus affinis hangulu, is a state animal of JNK. Hangul is a subspecies of Central Asian red deer. It is native to northern parts of India and found in dense riverine forests, mountains of Kashmir Valley and northern Chamba in Himachal Pradesh. Initially, the project failed due to lack of participation of local people, cement factories and militancy dealt. Further, this project was again launched with the name of Save Kashmir's Red Deer Hangul in 2009. Another attempt to save the Hangul was to breed it in captivity. Funds were sanctioned for captive breeding under the Species Recovery Program. Conservation breeding centers are opened at Sikagarh Trawl, Pulwama district and Kangan, but there is no much progress on increasing the numbers. Next one is Project Snow Leopard. Snow Leopard, also known as Mystical Apex Predator. The project was launched in January 2009 in 5 states of northern Himalayas. The project was initiated in hilly areas, high altitude areas above the forest in Himalayas, that is JNK, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh. It is a highly endangered species. They are mostly found in China and Mongolia other than India. This was an Indian initiative for strengthening wildlife conservation in Himalayan region. World Wide Fund India, in partnership with Tata Housing Development Company in January 2014, launched Save Our Snow Leopards project. Ladakh becoming role model in protecting snow leopard. The Ladakh region has set an example as a role model for leopard. This is an excellent example of cooperation among government and local community for success of any project. The Wildlife Department and several non-governmental organizations succeeded to prevent man-animal conflict and discouraged killing of exotic wild cats or snow leopards found in Trans-Himalayan Karakoram Mountains of the region and Central Asia. There are more than 400 wild cats found within the Indian territory in Ladakh. Next is Project One Horn Rhino. The Indian rhinoceros is also called the greater one-horned rhinoceros. It is listed as a vulnerable species under the IUCN Red List. Indian Rhino Vision 2020 was initiated by the Department of Environment and Forest, Assam, with the BODO Autonomous Council. This project will be supported by the Worldwide Fund Asian Rhino and Elephant Action Strategy, that is AREAS, International Rhino Foundation, IRF, and local non-governmental organizations to save rhinos. The main vision of this project is to increase the number of rhinos in Assam at least to 3,000 by the end of year 2020. The project also ensures that rhinos should be distributed over to at least 7 protected areas to provide future visibility. It also involves transfer of rhinos from one protected area to another. Manas National Park was the first park selected for the translocation of rhinos. Next is Project Ganges Dolphin. The Ministry of Environment and Forest has notified the Ganges River Dolphin as the national aquatic animal. On 5th October 2009, the Honorable Prime Minister of India had declared the Ganges River Dolphin as India's national aquatic animal. The river dolphin inhabits the region in Ganges, Brahmaputra, Meghna and Karnaphuli-Sangu river systems of Nepal, India and Bangladesh. It is listed in Schedule 1 for the Wildlife Protection Act 1972. The Ganges River dolphin was once present in tens of thousands of numbers but drastically decreased to less than 2,000 in the last century due to direct killing, river water pollution, accidental entanglement in fishing nets and poaching. Worldwide Fund India started to work with the local communities for the conservation of Ganges River dolphin in 1997. This campaign is highly popular and local community has contributed to a great extent. Vikramshila Gangetic Dolphin Sanctuary is located in Bhagalpur district of Bihar, India. It is a protected area for the endangered Gangetic dolphins in Asia. West Bengal is in process to establish the country's first community reserve for the mammal to protect the endangered Gangetic River dolphins. Next is Crocodile Project. Project Crocodile was started in 1975 with support from the Food and Agriculture Organization and United Nations Development Programme. This project is resultant of enactment of Wildlife Protection Act 1972. All these species of crocodile come under Project Crocodiles, Gharial, Gavialis Gangeticus, Mugger Crocodile. Second one is Crocodilus palustris and third one is saltwater crocodile. The objective of Project Crocodile was to protect the remaining population of crocodilians in their natural habitat by creating sanctuaries, to rebuild natural population quickly through grow and release or rear and release technique, to promote captive breeding. Project Sites. In 1976, it was conducted in river system of Bhitakanika area and Mahanadi, Orissa. The captive breeding program was carried out for gharials, crocodiles and mugger. Two projects under this are Bola project. It was conducted at Dangamal in Bhitakanika sanctuary of Odisha state. Bola is an Oriya term which means salt crocodile. The eggs were collected locally and young ones are released in estuaries and creeks. Second one is Mugger project in Ramatirtha, started in 1984 for care to mugger species. It is fish eater but harmless to humans. It lives in deep water. It is found in Indian subcontinent and being totally extinct from Bangladesh, Bhutan, Pakistan and Burma. Protecting gharials. Gharials come under critically endangered category of IUCN. In 1940s, around 10,000 adult gharials were estimated in the north of Indian subcontinent. But today, these are limited to nearly 200 adult individuals. It was reported in 2008, dozens of gharial are turning up dead on the banks of the Chambal River. Prague Zoo works together with an international organization called Gharial Conservation Alliance, GCA, to protect the last wild populations. This organization plays a key role in gharial conservation on the Chambal River. Its activities, however, are not limited to that zone, but extend throughout India Gharial Project at Tikkaparda. Capacitive breeding program carried out and has resulted in increased the number of gharials. Next project is Project Cheetah. Beginning of 20th century, the extinction of cheetah was making headlines. Government of India took an initiative as Project Cheetah to get back to their original state. It is the only large mammal which has been extinct from India in recent history. Supreme Court in 2012 set forth the Cheetah Reintroduction Program, by which the Ministry of Environment and Forests had proposed to import cheetah to India. The cheetah is found only in Africa, arid regions of eastern Iran in Asia. Kyono Palpur and Noradehi sanctuaries in Madhya Pradesh and Shahgarh landscape in Jaisalmer in Rajasthan have been selected by the Wildlife Institute of India as most suitable sites for the reintroduction project. Government of India is talking to Islamic Republic of Iran and African countries for export of cheetah. Next is Sea Turtle Project. The project was implemented by an NGO called Project Swarajya, located at Cuttack in Odisha. The sea turtles migrate from ocean to ocean and do not have any particular habitat except the female ones, who instinctively returns to the same beach year after year for laying its eggs. It feeds at the bottom of the ocean and comes outside periodically, outside the ocean only to replenish the oxygen. Today, 7 species of sea turtles such as flatback, olive ridley, Kemp's ridley, green hawksbill, leatherback and loggerhead are existing. Altogether, 5 out of the 7 species of sea turtles are found in the oceans of the Indian subcontinent, the olive ridley being the most populous amongst them. Gahirmatha Beach on the coast of Odisha, along the Bay of Bengal, in the place where thousands of them come during December and February to lay eggs. MOEF initiated the Sea Turtle Conservation Project in collaboration of UNDP in 1999 with Wildlife Institute of India, Dehradun, as the implementing agency. The project is being implemented in 10 coastal states of the country with special emphasis in state of Orissa. The project has helped in preparation of inventory map of breeding sites of sea turtles, identification of nesting and breeding habitats along the shoreline and migratory routes taken by sea turtles, development of guidelines to safeguard and minimize turtle mortality. One of the important achievements have been demonstration of use of satellite telemetry to locate the migratory route of olive ridley turtles in the sea, and sensitizing the fishermen and state government for the use of turtle exclusion device, that is TED, in fishing trawlers to check turtle mortality in fishing net. Next is vulture conservation. Vultures are those types of birds who feed on dead animals. It is found across the world, including Indian subcontinent. These have ecological, social and cultural significance in India. They are natural scavengers and helps to keep the environment clean. Presently, they are one of the most endangered bird species in India. This is a matter of great concern, as vultures are natural scavengers and play a crucial role in the ecosystem and are also essential for the overall well-being of environment and life support system. In 1998, observations and counts of vultures at Keoladeo National Park, Bharatpur, indicated a decline in number of vultures. In 1999, it was found that there is a sharp decline in number of vultures in India, Pakistan and Nepal. One of the major causes of decimation of population of vultures is the pharmaceutical drug diclofenac, which is toxic to the bird even at relatively low dosage. Research was focused around food shortages, poisoning, use of pesticides, disease or other factors. The report of Department of Animal Husbandry, Dairying and Fishing, the report of the Department of Animal Husbandry, Dairying and Fisheries made a shocking revelation on the population of vultures that had decimated in the entire region of South Asia. In May 2006, the Government of India initiated preventive actions to curb further decline in the population of vultures which also includes banning the use of diclofenac in veterinary sector. The government had released the Vulture Recovery Plan in 2006. The Bombay Natural History Society BHNS has led the movement of vulture conservation in India. In Asia, the first vulture conservation breeding center was opened at Pinjore, Haryana in 2005. At present, India has four vulture breeding facilities. First one is Rani, Guwahati, Assam. Second one is Pinjore in Haryana. Third one is Boksa in West Bengal. Fourth is Bhopal in Madhya Pradesh. Their four centers are managed by the Central Zoo Authority, CZA, in Junagadh in Gujarat, Nandankanan in Odisha, Hyderabad in Telangana, and Muta in Ranchi. From this discussion, we conclude that wildlife conservation is necessary for sustainable environment. So, the most important constituent of wildlife conservation is biosphere reserves. Biosphere reserves plays a significant role in biological diversity conservation. So, along with this, local communities also play a very important role because they are responsible for the success of any project. So, during the establishment of project, emphasis should be laid on the local community also. Thank you.